Hiya too, it's Aisha again. So this is our science video number 3. This is the last one for this week, and we're looking about plants and their habitats. I wonder what different plants you can think of. Why don't you pause the video and have a think and then come back and press play. So just like animals, plants also have habitats, and they are suited to the place where they live. And we're going to go through some different habitats and what plants are suited to that environment and that habitat, so keep watching. First habitat we're going to look at is desert. So a desert is a hot, dry place where not many plants can grow. Cacti can survive in the desert because they have a lot of shallow roots which collect any small amount of water in the ground. Their stems can store this water for a very long time. The spikes on a cacti are actually the leaves, and they protect the plant from being eaten by animals. And the spikes also stop air flowing near the cactus, which helps to keep the water in. So that's how they can survive in their habitat. We're then going to look at plants and the habitat, the seaside. So plants that live at the seaside need to be able to survive in strong winds, bright sunshine, salty air, and shallow sandy soil. That's what a habitat of a seaside would be like. So these plants, we're looking at plants, not animals, silly me, they need to be able to suit their environment.
Another habitat is the savanna. So the savanna is a large area of grassland in Africa. So where you see things like the Lion King, that setting, that habitat, that's what this would look like, the savanna. And animals such as lions, wildebeest, zebras and giraffe all live in the savanna. For a lot of the year, savannas are hot and dry, and plants that grow on the savanna have to have long, deep roots to reach underground water. And because there is no rain, there are often fires on savannas, so savanna trees have thick bark to protect themselves from these fires. However, during other parts of the year, there are heavy rains. Trees have thick trunks to store some of this water to use during the dry season. So there's two reasons there, and two ways in which these plants have adapted to suit their habitat. And then we have the habitat woodlands. Have you guys ever been to a forest? What could you hear, see and smell? Have a think. And then you might find these plants in woodlands, bluebells and ferns. And I wonder if you can think of any other plants that you might find in the woodland. And then we have under the sea. Plants need at least some sunlight to grow. So all plants need sunlight to grow. So in the deepest parts of the sea, plants can't grow. However, in more shallow water, plants can grow because the sun can still get to the plants in through the water. Some plants float on the surface of the water to get even more sunlight. So there you can have a look at some of the examples. You've got kelp, you've got seagrass and coralline algae. And they are all plants that have adapted to live under the sea. And that is the end for this video. There was a lot of information there. And there was a lot of information this week in all the videos. So it's really important that you pause the videos. Maybe you need to watch them more than once, and make sure you do the follow-up activity. So for this video where we looked at plant adaptations and plant habitats, there is an activity for you to do as well. Please send us a picture, post it on Seesaw. We really look forward to seeing all the great learning you've been doing at home. We miss you all incredibly, and we can't wait to see you hopefully soon, or speak to you again soon. Take care, year 2. Keep growing your brains big and strong, and looking after each other. Bye.